Here's where you are wrong, my friend. This woman has killed before.
Allegedly.
Okay, whatever. But she was a big girl. We are talking about a large, healthy woman of questionable stability.
Oh, you are totally underestimating the never-say-die scrappiness of a survivor.
Symbolism, you pussnut! I have to convince myself you're dead because you are killing me! Can't even masturbate anymore. Every time I bring out the lotion, it's poof.
Oh, hey, bud. Hey, rub one out right
now. Dude, if you solve my murder, I'll probably go away. I've been checking names off your eye for an eyelid. So.
I've been checking off names.
But me too! I don't want to have to be a villain without him. I don't have that kind of staff rack's grudge. I just want to help my best friend with his hate. You guys. Monarch crew. Hedge for a life.
Hey, guess what? Nobody cares who would win in a crazy fantasy fistfight between Anne Frank and Lizzie Borden. We never should have brought the henchmen. We're gonna be the only ones there with henchmen. I'm gonna have to kill them. Pull over if you see a good place to dump their bodies.
I can't take this. Do you want me to turn around? Because I will. You're the one that won.
Yes. Monarch Mobile Submersible Mode!
What are you doing?
Engage the submarine function!
Do we have that?
Yes! Maybe I just thought we did. Hit that button!
Nice. You turned the wipers on.
Fuck it! Hit the ejector! Abandon ship!
We don't have it!
What do we have?
Cup holders?
By the keeper. I'm so proud of you, sweetie.
I, Saprax, wish to cross.
What is your business on the other side?
I found your doll.
That's an action figure.
No, this is your old dolly.
Give it! She's mine!
Trey was yours. Dad put a price tag on it.
Well, it's not his to sell.
All right, I'm over it. Let's get Dean his fake girlfriend back. Come on, we gotta do it. Dermot, you want in?
Go, Team Fisher!
You're not gonna break my legs.
Okay, then check this out. Hank and I are gonna write her name on the lawn with logs. Then we're gonna friggin' light it on fire. You're gonna be all gothed out standing there, and it's gonna be this huge wall of flames, and you're gonna be like the Crow. She's gonna see that shit and cream herself.
Do you have a pamphlet or something for me to read?
I can't believe they're still on this. Why can't you just grasp how unpredictable our plumbing is?
I don't know, man. What if you were about to slide into third and the base was all hosed down? You'd freak too. She's got a point.
So what are we gonna do? I don't think they're terrorists, but I'm OSI, so, you know.
I don't know about OSI protocol, but I say we deal with this like we used to back in the day.
Sniper rifles? One to the brain?
What? No, psycho. We go...
It's like... sad. Like you gave up, like you have nothing to live for. Okay, fine. I gotta go. But just please tell me you know what I meant.
I know what you meant. But please tell me you'll give Skins a go.
I will. Goodbye, Helper Model 2.
Goodbye, Rusty Venture.
Ugh, you have to learn how to relax. This has a lock on it. We'll be fine.
I just think that with all your advertising.
Who even opens those Val packs anyway?
You have some dangerous machinery for sale here. I think you're begging for trouble on this one.
I thought you handled all that. And I don't hear any big ideas from you on how to get some quick cash. Come on. Most of this stuff is old crap my dad left behind.
Doc, you have a table over there with a sign that says Laser Death Ray Bargain Bin.
What was worse, my prom date was to have been Miss Linda Lovelace.
Deep throat Linda Lovelace?
The same. She, of course, by that time was a vocal anti-pornography advocate, thanks, Dad, and sent her friend Andrea Dworkin as her proxy.
Was she hot?
Google Andrea Dworkin on an empty stomach one day. Oh, hello? Yes, I'd like 6 of your finest whores, please. Fine, escorts. Yes, I think I'll go for full service. Sure, I'll hold. Anyway, because my dad brought like 10 Dallas Cowboy cheerleaders as his date, he didn't care that my date was a huge, angry, way smarter than a 16-year-old me woman who called me Little Half-Man.
I'm gonna give you a Rusty Venture.
Don't believe the hype. A Rusty Venture is the name for when you jerk off so much your dick gets all red and sore.
Really?
Yeah, but I'll let you give me an Action Johnny.
Ooh, what's that?
I'll show you. Beat it, rookie. Need the room.
Yes. Of course, sir. I'm not exactly up and ready in that capacity.
That's so cool. That's a direct call from Big Brass. It's so important he has a hotline.
Yeah, well, he never reads his email.
And I'm flattered, but can't you send Captain Whoever to deal with it?
It's a job, King.
Brock, you want to go Team Venture with me?
I gotta hold down the fort. Ask Adrian.
Good idea.
He's kind of, you know, manly.
Totally. And I heard from a reliable source.
that he has a surgically implanted baboon's uterus.
Can they even do that?
Your naivete is alarming. I have personally grafted a pony's face onto the abdomen of a well-known celebrity.
Is it someone I've heard of?
I do not kiss and tell.
Holy crap!
Who are you?
Oh, great and powerful Zeus, I am but a humble savant.
I'm fucking scientist, boy. Zeus is a myth, and this guy's kidnapping me.
Wait, you are in charge?
Yeah, I'm the brains here.
What? Since when? I'm running this show, and you know it.
Are you high? You do nothing. Nothing.
I'm the idea man.
You look like a can of Diet Pepsi.
At least I don't look like the girl from the Blind Melon video.
Well, her stinger didn't shoot dots, and her wings didn't actually work. Huh? Huh? Yeah, okay, these don't either.
Big Chris boy, the storm is coming for you.
For the singular design of grooming my lawn!
All right, keep it. Just take it down a notch.
Sorry, I just... You said you would return it. I get like that. Do you need a hand here? I'm a people person. I could assist you vending your sundries. Why, I would make a whiz-bang salesman.
Fine, you deal with the creepy guys dressed like special creepy guys.
I love you, too. Come get a hug.
No, not you. I'm talking to my dead friend.
Oh, a ghost. That's my game. Where is he?
You don't see him?
Is it Bruce Willis?
Oh, it's 24, and his dead advisor, Mr. Wendell, who's that guy from the Arrested Development video.
Mr. Wendell? You mean Baba O.J.?
Their advisor, the old guru guy.
That was Baba O.J., living in my astral form. But the Triad and I are currently ensconced in bumper-upon-bumper traffic on your Franklin Delano Roosevelt Drive. Is Mr. Sampson not joining us?
He refuses to sleep in here. That's how serious this is. It's Scarabrock spooky!
Achda Byron Orpheus, master metaphysician, president, and founder of the Order of the Triad.
Yes, hello, Orpheus. I know you.
Oh, do you?
You're on counter. Look alive!
Here he is. No! No, helper! Whatever you do, do not engage your helicopter blades!
Buddy, did you get spooked too?
A little bird told me. But don't blame Tiny Eagle. We all saw this coming.
Well, it's a complete lie. I cannot be happier.
This isn't happening in here. It's like 2 inches higher than the one at the cocoon. Throwing me all out of whack.
We all know the good doctor could turn the world of professional villainy upside down if she would just try it on her own and drop things.
Look, I've got a good thing going on here. I'm not the same person you used to know.
Okay, Fulcum, that sound you heard was nothing. But some of the pressure has been released.
You know, I'm between hating scientists now.
SPORM. It's an acronym for the classic panoply of powers every professional villain team needs. Speed, power, air, water, magic. The W can also stand for wind or weather, but you definitely need at least one elemental in the mix.
Gonna go through with this?
It's the only way.
Drop them in measure.
Are we measuring from the top or
from the base? Let's try to keep a little dignity.
I thought it cool.
No, I thought you thought it was cool.
Oh, okay, crazy. Then by your logic, you think you broke my space station.
Tried everything.
Are you kidding me? You were just flipping switches. Think. Think, Tiny Wonder. You built this with me. You should know her inside and out.
I was like 10. I just wanted to play with my plastic cowboys and...
Remember, Rusty, in here I'm your doctor, not your father. Now, let's get back to it, shall we? You were telling me how you're ungrateful for all the opportunities your father's given you, and you blame me for all your problems. I tried to communicate with them, but they mustn't teach the cadets Morse code anymore. Soon, the blackness came for me again. But I knew I was on Gargantua 1. I built her. I could communicate with her. We had a miscommunication. I was alone, disconnected, forced to forage for protein as my back.